I'm Jeffrey Warren, 2023 Innovator in Residence at the Library of Congress, and I'm going to show a little bit about the process of modeling buildings from historical records.
In my work virtually reconstructing Providence Chinatown, I've shared videos like this one, which is the first moment I had enough buildings rebuilt that it really felt like a neighborhood. The process of creating a model like this is involved, but the basic steps aren't so hard and are similar for each building. This part of the Relational Reconstruction Guide will focus on how to begin 3D modeling using archival records. Let's look at some of the techniques I've used. But keep in mind, the best way to learn is together, and I'll be hosting workshops on these techniques in the spring and summer of 2023. We'll cover tracing building footprints, creating surfaces from photos, and applying those to the model. Often, as shown in the research portion of the guide, I use maps to understand a space at a moment in time. If you have a map showing buildings you're interested in, and you have a pretty flat area like Providence's Chinatown, you can import the map into a 3D program to begin modeling on it. But first you'll need to get the scale right. Many maps, including Sanborn insurance maps at the Library of Congress, have a scale reference. If you don't have such a scale reference, you could try measuring a big building in the real world, or you could try measuring streets. But think about how streets may have widened or narrowed over the years, and how sidewalks and curbs change. Some neighborhoods aren't on flat ground, of course. I won't go in depth on terrain here, but if your site is on a hillside, or for example a river valley, you can approximate the terrain by tracing contours and then draping a surface over them. More rural Chinatowns and ethnic enclaves were sometimes on steep ground, which is harder to build on and less accessible, but this also enabled them to be more protected and enclosed. Once you have your map scaled and oriented, you can trace the footprints of buildings on its surface and pull them up from the map to create a very rough model of the neighborhood. If you know building heights, you can adjust those as well. Repeat this for as many buildings as you can. Now, although things are probably strange colors, you have a very rough idea of how different buildings were organized in 3D space. Now I'll show how we can take old photographs like these and map them onto the buildings we've made. I collected these over many months, but now I feel like I have enough to work on this building. For more on finding images, see the research portion of this guide. If you have a variety of photos of a building, many of them partial, it can help to diagram the building surfaces out. We choose as front-facing a photo as we can at the highest resolution available and trace the edge of the building surface. Now I'll use the free transform tool or the perspective distort tool to flatten the facade as if we were facing it straight on. You may need to combine multiple photos to get a complete facade. Sometimes, if a building has a lot of repeated elements, like windows, it can be worthwhile to use one high-resolution photo to stitch together a much higher-resolution image of the whole facade. This can start to become more speculative, however, if there are details like the staircases and balconies in this example photo, where you aren't completely sure of the original appearance. But it's helpful to keep careful note of what you're basing on a clear photograph versus what you're speculating about. Now, if you have forms ready to apply the facades to, you can do so. Did the building have a gabled roof? Did it have insets or overhangs or columns? At a certain point, you may want to look for free-to-use textures to supplement your model. These could be cropped from old photos from the period or taken from texture libraries with free-to-use images. Now you can repeat the last step with other facades if you have them. I did a lot of image stitching to get a clearer picture of the front of this building. But you don't have to do this. For other buildings, I intentionally left the newsprint texture to show where the image came from. This is a powerful step for me, where we start to get a feeling for the neighborhood through its textures and visual language. Sometimes we can see people walking down the street or paused on a sidewalk. It's at this point that I sometimes feel I'm crafting a space for someone, smoothing out the kinks in the sidewalks, leaving space for gardens or private nooks, sweeping and tidying up their space which has long sat gathering dust. At this point, you may want to begin making your buildings into separate groups within the model. It will help you organize your work and will be more difficult to do later. Flipping or mirroring a photo can help you complete an incomplete facade. It can be hard to know how tall to make a building, but you can use reference photos to estimate those heights in comparison to nearby buildings. Try comparing different angles to photographs of the place to see if you can see things match up. Once your buildings are in place, there are likely still a lot of surfaces in your model which remain bare, and it may help to add textures to things like yards, alleys, and sidewalks. You could also add vegetation or things like benches, streetlights, crates, or other things which help to flesh out the scene a bit. You don't need to model the whole city. Sometimes even a couple buildings can be enough to create a compelling feeling of a place. In a later section, I'll show how lighting and atmospheric effects, as well as materials and textures, can help to create emotional tone. It's worthwhile to try this even with a partial model to get a better feeling for the space, for example, at night. Above all, I've tried to focus on the feeling of a particular place or moment, rather than trying to create a complete or highly detailed model. Where might residents of this place have sat and watched people walk by, taken a nap, or sat back and daydreamed?
That wraps up this tutorial. For more information, you can see the written guide online.